As part of building a new building, the interdisciplinary sciences building, we got a grant in order to get new equipment to get our research up and going.
I had some of the anesthesia students interested in Drosophila. We had a student who took an exposed larva and watched them and started seeing if we could follow gene changes.
Some of my students, they were interested in insects, so we began working with ants. We started doing research projects looking at their activity.
One of the projects that I'm working on right now deals with microbial diversity. There was this natural area that was being developed on campus. I recruited some students and we were taking water samples from the natural area over time and then looking to see how did that bacterial diversity change. We wanted to buy a sequencer because there were several members of the faculty that were really interested in doing sequencing projects. There are services that we could send libraries to get sequenced elsewhere. However, we really felt strongly that the students should have hands-on experience with the sequencer and see the process from beginning to end. And we tried to identify equipment that would be usable by a good number of faculty members. And the MiniSeq was one of those that a number of us felt like we could all use.
The user platform is so simple to use. And even if we went to RNA sequencing in a human system, this would still meet of all of our needs. And then it was even better that it fit within our price range.
When the instruments showed up, the students, they were saying, this looks so cool. And there were a few students, they saw it and they said immediately, I want to sequence something.
The MiniSeq is awesome, very useful for anything that involves the sequencing of our live species that we do research on a daily basis.
It's amazing that now at the undergraduate level we are able to do it, because only a few years ago it was just something you know I saw on TV.
The MiniSeq for me in undergraduate studies is huge, really. The ability to map out the genome and the expression of two different behaving species.
And it's bringing science to a community that may otherwise not have been exposed to this. Being in this new building, in this collaborative atmosphere with several different departments, and having the drop-in lab where they can see us working on the MiniSeq, it's going to open up real avenues of communication and respect and understanding.
By having that MiniSeq, it really brings all of those things together and helps them develop all of those skills, which will, in the end, help them get jobs in industry in the area or in academia in the area. It'll provide them experiences in order to continue on into graduate school. And I think overall, it's just going to open their minds up to the possibilities of what you can do with all of this technology.
How it feels to me to know that one of my students may cure cancer, Alzheimer's, Parkinson's, is pretty immense. That's what I hope. That would be my dream.